We have an idea how buildings are built, floor by floor or layer by layer. This is what we're doing in our lab, but at the nanoscale. 2D materials let us build unprecedented nanostructures with entirely new functionality. So let's go into the lab and see what makes 2D materials so special. This chip that I'm holding in my hand has a semiconductor layer that's exactly 3 atoms thick. Now that's incredible. Now every day at Columbia, we make nano devices by stacking 2D materials into complex structures. To understand what's special about 2D materials, let's take a look at two things that you're familiar with. A diamond ring and graphite, or commonly called pencil lead. Both are made entirely of carbon. But this is a 2D material, and this is a 3D or bulk material. To understand the differences between a diamond and graphite, let's look at the molecular models. This is the molecular model for diamond. Each black ball represents a carbon atom, and the white lines in between them represent the covalent bonds between the atoms. As you can see, the diamond lattice is periodic, extending in all 3 dimensions. Now compare the diamond lattice to the graphite lattice here. As you can see, the bonding is very different. In graphite, there are multiple planes that are not bonded together. A single layer of graphite is called graphene. These layers can slide past each other, which leads to the good lubricating properties of graphite powder. It's this planar, layered structure that's unique to 2D materials. It lets graphite write and diamond not. 2D materials can have interesting properties that surpass that of conventional materials. But more importantly, they represent a whole new way to build structures, one atomic layer at a time. And using this new type of building, we can create structures that before were not thought possible. This opens up a realm of possibilities, from flexible electronics to implantable biomedical devices to spray-on applications. Perhaps what's most exciting about this field is that the materials are in their infancy and this process was newly created. This opens up a whole new toolbox to enable future discoveries. In part 2, we'll have a visual how-to on the layer-by-layer stacking process to create nanostructures from 2D materials.